Most people know this trick where you can add all dates between the start date and an end date by adding number from start date, number from end date. This gives you a list of all dates in number format. But I'm gonna show you an even smarter way that can tackle multiple scenarios such as dates, end of week, end of month, end of year, with the same reusable formula by adjusting only one value. And yes, you should add this formula to your coding notes, as this formula will come in handy very often. Furthermore, this method is much more performance effective, especially with larger datasets, as we do all the data manipulation before extracting the date lists to our data table. So let's look at that. In this dataset, we have a start date and an end date, and we start by extracting all dates. Next, we'll extract end of month, and lastly, end of years. We can do all the needed data manipulation in one step by adding a custom column. We add let and in. This can be seen as your syntax with a variable and a return statement. We add the variable dateList and use the built-in formula listDates and add three arguments. First, we add startDate. Next, we declare the duration as a number, endDate minus startDate. And lastly, the incremental value. As we want each date within the range, the incremental value is set to 1 here. Now we have achieved the same result as the first example, where we have all dates between start and end date. But since our values are dates instead of numbers, we can use the built-in date functions in Power Query to only extract end of week, end of month, end of year, and the like. We add a variable called endValues. Here we add listTransform and add our previous variable dateList. Then add a comma and add date.endofday. As we only want distinct values, we surround the formula with listDistinct. Lastly, we update the return slash in function with the new variable. Now the return values are the distinct end of day, as we can see when we expand the columns. This formula is very neat, as it is completely reusable no matter what your need is. You can just change the date argument and you will get your needed value, for example, end of year, end of day, end of week, or the like. That's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe. Bye for now.